effect we feel that this is a tafsir of muttaqin, because Quran talks about muttaqin a number of times. If you just see the word waqa, that means to protect or do parhezgari, and then muttaqin appears in Quran so often. So Imam is, you know, praying to Allah, Albisni zinat al-muttaqin, oh Allah, clothe me in the ornaments of muttaqin. Fi, not through what? And yesterday we mentioned about 9 items. Today is about 10, but we'll just mention a few of them. Others will just go quickly. So Imam says, wa husna sirah, no, by beauty of conduct. Make sure that our conduct, no, our sirah, for example, we say siratun nabi, right? Sirah, that means the conduct, no, or the way of living. So it should be a beauty, our way of living, our, no, for example, sirah, people look at it and say it's beautiful. Sukun ri, no, calmness of disposition. Try to know disposition again is also akhlaq, should calmness, right? Watibil mukhalaka, and agreeableness in comportment. No, that means again your akhlaq, and if be tiba, that means it's pleasant, it's agreeableness or present in comportment, right? Then of course a sabq idal fadila, precedence in reaching excellence. Sabak is try to always, for example, when we try to race, that is sabak, right? Musabika. For example, in Arabic, musabika is a race, no? Sabki ilal fadila. You try to proceed towards excellence, no? In reaching excellence. Try to, remember, we also started this dua by saying that, no, Imam uses the superlative degrees, number of things. So try to reach the excellence and proceed in doing that, no? Isar al-tafaddul. This is, I have underlined, because this is the actually peak. Isar is something which, you know, only few of us are blessed with. Actually, when I am discussing this thing, I'm pointing a finger at myself that may Allah give us that ability to have isar. Isar is what? Isar is, you know, you try to prefer others over yourself. We have in Quran, for example, Surah 59, Surah Al-Hashr, ayat number 9, whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the quality of Ansar. Allah says about Ansar that when Muhajirin came to Medina from Makkah, and they were completely, you know, penniless, right? Because they were driven out of Makkah, they came there, and people of Medina welcomed them. Not only that, they welcomed them, and then they started giving preference to them, no? So Allah says, Bismillah ar-Rahman, وَيُؤْسِرُونَ عَلَىٰ نُفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَسَاسًا. These people, this what, people of Medina, they used to prefer the Muhajir over themselves, though poverty was their way. That means, although they themselves were poor, but they would give preference to Muhajirin. SubhanAllah, Isar. Let me share with you a beautiful story, which, although I know I'm talking to elders here, they are not kids, but sometimes it really what drives in, you know, drives home the point. There was, you know, Abdullah ibn Ja'far al-Tayyar, the husband of Janabi Zainab al-Salam. He was known to be a great, generous person, very generous. If you just look at his life, I'm surprised that we have not seen a booklet on the life of Abdullah ibn Ja'far al-Tayyar. He was really a generous person. One day he happened to see a servant. He just was passing by, saw a servant, a slave, who was, just as he was working, a time of, you know, lunch came, so his food was brought to him. So when the food was brought to the servant, Abdullah was just around there, and he saw that he's about to start his food, and a dog came. And clearly the dog was hungry, you know. So this person took a portion of his food and gave it to the dog. After giving that portion, he saw that the dog is still standing there, as if that means he's not finished eating. So he gave the second portion of his food, you know. Again, the dog ate that thing, and still the dog could not move, as if it was still hungry. So the last portion remaining, he just gave it to him. Abdullah was surprised. Abdullah went to the slave and says that, are you going to get another food? He said, no, this is the food of my, no, for the day. This is what we get. That's all. We don't get anything more than that. So he said, what are you going to do? He said, I'll just spend the rest of the day without it. But because I felt that this dog was more hungry than me, I just gave it to him. Abdullah was so much impressed by this slave, subhanAllah. He went to the owner of the slave. he purchased the slave and also purchased the entire garden where he was working. And then he gave that garden as a gift to this slave. You see, this is ithar tafaddul, no? That means you try to prefer others, no? And this is the, we look at some of the hadith, this is actually the peak of akhlaq, honestly, ithar. That means you always never look at the self, look at others, no? And this is something we should pray to Allah, that Allah give us. وَتَرْكِ التَّعَيِّيرِ And try to refrain from condemning. التَّعَيِّيرِ actually comes from the word ar. Ar, that means, for example, you expose somebody and try to find fault, right? Try to abandon that thing, no? It's very easy to criticize. Never rush to criticize. Always, if you find, especially in a community setting, right? If you go to, just now the Imam Baghas are closed, inshallah we pray that, you know, soon we'll be allowed to go back to Masajid and Imam Baghas. But once you go there, if you find something not there, instead of criticizing it, ask the question, what can I do to improve them? If that Allah khairil mustahikin, if that subhanAllah, and then Imam says that bestowing bounty on the undeserving, غير مستحقين. That means sometimes somebody does not deserve, but even then you give preference, you give to them. Not because they deserve, because of your akhlaq. It is your akhlaq that no oversees who the person is, you still give. وَالْقَوْلِ بِالْحَقِّ وَإِنْ عَزَّى SubhanAllah. Again, this is something which is not easy. No. The speech which is of truth, even if it is difficulty, even if it is heavy, even it is, for example, you know, speaking the truth, although it is painful or heavy, and again, we go back to Janabi Zainab, salam, that Janabi Zainab is considered as a mujahida, you know, who did not take a sword to fight, but she used her tongue to speak truth in the darbar of Kufa and Sham, and in the bazaar of Kufa and Sham. No? That is why the hadith says, Akbarul Jihad, Kalimatul Haq in the Sultan al Jai, right? The biggest jihad is speaking truth in the presence of a leader who is despot, a leader who is known to be ruthless. Even Janabi Zainab alayhi salam had that courage to speak the truth. No? So, والقول بالحق وإن عز واستقلال الخير وإن كثر من القول وفعل واستثار الشر وإن قل من القول وفعل. These two points also are very great. No? استقلال الخير واستثار الشر. I can see here people who have got children. May Allah give them, keep them healthy and successful. But this quality, استقلال الخير واستثار الشر. As parents, we should be very careful. Istiqlal al-khair, that means, whatever good you do, always try to consider as that nothing, but it's little. Just minimize it. Don't try to say, nobody can do good like me. Especially, sometimes parents actually spoil their children by trying to praise their children. No, istiqlal al-khair. Try to just make your good to look so minimum, insignificant. Even if, for example, people say it's great, or if it looks like great in speech or in deed, but even then, just you try to minimize it. No, diminish the good you do. Because why? Others do more than you. And secondly, even good I do, that is on account of what Allah has given me, right? On account of my parents raising, on account of so many other things, support of my spouse, so many things can be there that we can do. So istiqlal is khair. No, istiqlal means qalil. It's about a qalil, right? Istiqlal means seeking less, seeking low in khair. Whatever good you do, never try to exaggerate it, no? And then istiqsar is shar. But when it comes to bad, something evil, try to make it a big deal that, no, I should not have done it. Being a preacher, being a leader, being something, how can I do something wrong, no? So istiqsar is shar, wa in kalla min qawli wa fi'li. Even people say, no, don't worry, this is a small thing. No, but still, no, I should not have done it. Keep in mind, and that is why we say that gunah kabira and gunah sagira applies to ordinary people. For an alim, when he does gunah sagira, it's like gunah kabira for him, right? Because he's not expected to do this thing. So istighfar sharri wa inkalla. Akmil thalika li bidawam itta'a wa luzum al jama'a wa rafdi ahad al bid'a. An Imam says, no, perfect all these qualities, these 14 qualities, through what? Through lasting obedience, that I should continue lasting, holding fast to the community, right? your jama'ah, your community, try to hold to them, right? Don't try to, for example, just isolate. وَرَفْضِ الْأَهْلِ الْبِدْعَ And try to, you know, just reject people of innovation, people who do bid'ah, try to stay away. مُسْتَعْمِ الْرَعِيِ الْمُخْتَرِ And try to acknowledge the original opinions, no? Instead of making your own opinion, try to do that, no? So that is as far as du'a is concerned. As we say that, no, when it comes to ithar, look at some of the hadiths very clearly, no? Because this is, ithar is actually the peak of akhlaq, no? Afdal al-sakha al-isar, Imam says in a Ghul al-Hikam, the best form of generosity is self-sacrifice, that, you know, you as this slave did, right? And then he says, وَغَايَةُ makarim isar. Do you see the word Imam used? Makarim, same as makarim akhlaq, you see? The peak of virtues, the peak of best akhlaq is what? Self-sacrifice, you see? And then Imam says, al-isaru ahsan al-ihsan. وَأَعْلَى مَرَاتِبِ الْإِيمَانِ Right? Self-sacrifice is the best kindness in the highest rank of belief. Keep this in mind, that this, your faith, your iman is reflected in, also in akhlaq. How much, no, selfless a person is also shows his faith. And we shared with you this, what the story of Abdullah bin Jafar and the slave who sacrificed his dog. And also we discussed with you the ayat 9, right? We now go to a trip on the month of Ramadan. Yesterday there was a question regarding, you know, somebody was questioning about rules when you are fasting and traveling. Maulana Rizvi has a site, al-m.ca, that is his site. If you go there and just see travel, there is a special, he has taken pain to, you know, include all those masais. When you are fasting, if you travel, what are the masais rules, you know? So I would encourage the sister who was there from New York yesterday to perhaps refer to